Hi everyone, myself Dr. Kartika. Hope everyone is doing well, and today's video is on COVID vaccination in females. I think this video will clear most of your doubts regarding COVID vaccination in females, pregnant women as well as a lactating woman. Let's go into the video. Available vaccine in India too. One is Covaxin, another thing is Covishield. Covaxin is an inactivated killed whole virus vaccine which is produced by Bharat Biotech Limited, whereas Covishield is a viral vector vaccine which is produced by Serum Institute of India in collaboration with AstraZeneca. And the first and foremost question in everyone's mind is vaccination in a pregnant woman. This vaccinating a pregnant woman is still a debate because of the limited available data on the use of COVID-19 vaccine in pregnancy, the two regarding the vaccine that is available in India. But the benefit of vaccinating a woman far outweigh the theoretical as well as the remote risk of vaccination. So, FOCI recommends administering this COVID-19 vaccine to all pregnant women after explaining the risk and benefit of vaccine to the pregnant woman. And also, FOCI defers this vaccination in first trimester because till now the data says there is no teratogenicity of COVID-19 vaccine, but as I said already, the data is limited and is not substantial. So, we have to defer the vaccination in first trimester. And the next question is regarding the day of menses. A woman can have the vaccination on any day of menses, even during her menstruation. The next common doubt will be, doctor, I'm undergoing infertility treatment, either IVF or IUA or any ovulation induction treatment. I'm trying for a pregnancy. What I have to do for vaccination? So the answer for this question is no need to defer the vaccination for infertility treatment or you're waiting for a pregnancy, because there is no evidence that vaccine administration affects a pregnancy outcome. And second thing is you no need to wait for a pregnancy test also before vaccination. And the third most common question is, I was not aware of my pregnancy. So I inadvertently had this COVID-19 vaccine. What I have to do? Even people's terminating their pregnancy because of vaccinating. So in such cases, please don't terminate your pregnancy, because already I said the evidence says vaccine doesn't have any teratogenic effect to the fetus. But since the evidence is limited, I just told you to postpone your vaccination in a second or third trimester. But you should not terminate the pregnancy if you took it by mistake in your early pregnancy. And in case of past COVID infection, what to do? Even if you had COVID-19 infection in your past, vaccination is advisable in a pregnant woman. If you are now currently infected with COVID-19, wait for 3 months for vaccination. Or if you have recovered from the infection, you can wait for 4 to 8 weeks, then you can vaccinate yourself. Then coming to the pregnancy with comorbidities, even you have any comorbidities, hypertension, diabetes, anything, any severe comorbidities, it is not a contraindication for COVID-19 vaccination. So coming to the breastfeeding woman, actually the breastfeeding woman, if you vaccinate yourself, the first thing is you will protect yourself from COVID-19 vaccination, and second thing is you will be passing those antibodies through the breast milk to the neonate, and also you will protect your baby. So you have an additional benefit of vaccination. So the method of administration, monitoring and the schedule of vaccination is same for the pregnant as well as the lactating woman as for the general population. So coming to the contraindication, only in two conditions you have no need to vaccinate yourself. One is already you had a first dose of vaccination and you got some allergic reaction to that. So please don't take your second dose of vaccination. Or already you had an immediate or a delayed onset anaphylaxis or an allergic reaction to vaccination or injectable therapies, pharmaceutical products or food item, etc. Don't have your COVID-19 vaccination. And there are some conditions where you have to postpone the vaccination. The first thing is, already I said, when you are diagnosed COVID-19 infection, defer for 3 months from the infection or 4 to 8 weeks from the recovery. Or now you are having some active symptoms of COVID-19 infection, fever, sore throat, myalgia, anything. First go and test for COVID-19 infection. Then you can have your or schedule your vaccination. or already you had a COVID-19 infection, and that time you are treated with anti-COVID-19 monoclonal antibodies or convalescent plasma, or you are acutely unwell or hospitalized due to some non-COVID reasons, either in ICU or without ICU support. In this condition, you can defer the vaccination for 8 weeks. Vaccinating yourself with COVID-19 vaccination doesn't mean that you are 100% protective. In spite of vaccination, you have to follow all safety measures like wearing double mask or N95 mask, staying at home, maintaining social distancing, and using hand sanitizer on and off. Let's stand together and prevent against COVID-19 infection. Thank you.